It's all on the line here in Le Mans. Last lap underway. Jorge Martin has an advantage of just over a tenth of a second. Here comes Pekka Bagnaia. He is hunting as they go through the high-speed first corner. He is not going to be close enough to attack Martin into the Dunlop chicane.
Martin ever so slightly wide, and Marc Marquez is right back on this pair now. Anything between this leading pair, and it might be the opportunity the 93 needs.
Down through La Chapelle, chapeau to these three here in this French Grand Prix. Martin's just that slightly wider, but the door not open wide enough for Bagnaia to sweep on through. Marquez still there, looking very menacing in third place as they come through seven for the final time.
Garage Vert, a big opportunity, one of the big braking stops that they're coming up to now, and then Shimano above. Surely Bagnaia dare not leave it until recall them on the final corner.
He must know as well that Marquez will be going for the late attack. Bagnaia is running out of time here. Likewise, Marc Marquez on the number 93 bike. Jorge Martin is, what, five corners away from the victory of his career. Here comes Marc Marquez on the inside of Pekka Bagnaia. What a move that was. What a move by Marquez. He takes second place. That is Bagnaia's victory hopes here in Le Mans gone.
And Jorge Martin surely now come to the clear. An opportunistic move from Marquez, which has secured him second place, or has it?
Will Bagnaia fight back? These two have had already their big tussle so far in 2024, but through the final corner we go. Let the fireworks start here in France, because it is pure magic from Jorge Martin. He smashes the screen on the Prima Pramac Ducati. He takes the win in a memorable, brilliant French Grand Prix. He takes the checkered flag by nearly half a second. Marc Marquez with the last lap attack on Pekka Bagnaia. He wasn't going to wait for Bagnaia to attack Martin on the front foot, on the offensive. Marquez back-to-back second places from 13th place. Bibendum waves the checkered flag. Bagnaia has to settle for third. He was obviously thinking, wasn't he, about a late move on Jorge Martin, but he had to factor in that you've got one of the most ruthless riders in history behind you. Marc Marquez has produced two unbelievable comebacks. 13th to second in the sprint yesterday. We thought it was all on, a big ask for him to repeat that today, and he has delivered once again. Second place for Marquez. Jorge Martin's lost the screen. He's lost his visor. He won't care one bit, because that has got to be his best win in the MotoGP. One of the best of his Grand Prix career. Win number 17. Magnificent seven for Jorge Martin here in Le Mans. Magnifique, I think it's fair to say. What a Grand Prix. What a race. Three of the best talents. Yeah, big cry of vamos, come on, from Jorge Martin. That was special.
Is the best rider in the world right now? Jorge Martin just laid his marker down right there. He was under so much pressure in those closing stages. He played the early game of following Bagnaia, took his opportunity. We thought Bagnaia was going to struggle to stay with Martin later on. He did stay with Martin, and as you say, Bagnaia's thoughts were all on Martin, it felt like, on that final lap. Marc Marquez, with the opportunism into Shimano above, snatched second place.